Hi, I'm Yaakov Choter from gypsyandjazz.com, and in this lesson I will show you the octave part in Django Reinhardt's improvisation over minor swing, the 1947 recording. You will learn how to create your own stunning octave part in your improvisation, and also how to arrange your improvisation in a structure that sounds good. Doesn't matter what your skills are. But first, let's learn the octave part so you can play it, and then we'll implement it over other songs and in your own improvisation. 1, 2, 3, and. Just a short overview of how I hold my octaves and mute all the other strings if you don't do it properly yet. For example, we start with the note of E on the 5th and the 3rd string on the 7th and 8th fret. So with my index string, I press the 5th string and mute the 6th string. I also mute the 4th string. So you see with my index, I mute the 4th and the 6th and play the 5th string. With my ring finger, I play the note of E on the 3rd string on the 9th fret, and I mute the 2nd and the 1st string. And here I can hit and strum over all the strings, and still you hear only my 5th and 3rd strings. When I play on my 4th and 2nd string for the next note of A, this is the 2nd shape, we have A on the 4th string on the 7th fret and A on the 2nd string on the 10th fret. With my index finger, I mute the 5th string and the 3rd string, and with my pinky, I play the 2nd string and mute the 1st, and with my ring, a middle finger, I mute the 6th and 5th string as well. And you see my ring finger is free, I don't use it here. And that way you hear only the 4th and the 2nd string. And you don't hear other strings. So we start with the note of E that I showed you before, and the note of A, half tone below, half tone above. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, and 4, and. Rhythm is very important. You play on the beat. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, and 4, and. So you have syncopes. 1, 2, 3, and 4, and. 1, 2, 3, 4. Then, half tone above to the note of F. And you already see that this note, E and A, are part of the A minor chord. Then we change to D minor, so it's the same idea, the same motif, but Django uses the notes of D minor, F, and B. B is the 6th of D minor 6, so we have the note of B on the 9th and 12th fret of the 4th and the 2nd string. So, same tempo, same rhythm pattern. So from the top, 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, and 4, and 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, and 4, and 1, 2, 3, 4. Again, so you can play with me. 1, 2, 3, 4. 2, 3, and 4, and 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, and 3, and 4, and 1, 2, 3, 4. So by now, we played a 2-bar sentence. Which this is something important, because in this octave part in Django Reinhardt, we have a structure that beats like that. 2-bar sentence, and then again, 2-bar sentence, which is the same idea. You just change the note according to the chord, and then it followed by a 4-bar sentence. And I will demonstrate for you shortly after I will teach you the last phrase, how beautiful your improvisation can be if you start to think in structure and play 2-bar sentence, 2-bar sentence followed by 4-bar sentence. It's something that it's easy to implement And you'll hear how it will make your improvisation much more interesting when you start to think in sentences and in structure rather than just playing licks. You can play your licks, but if you organize them in the structure, it makes it much beautier. Now let's see the last sentence. Okay, this is a four bar sentence. Let me show it to you. It starts on the fourth quarter on the previous bar, 1, 2, 3, 4, with the note of F sharp on the 9th and 11th fret of the 5th and 3rd strings. And then on the 2nd string, you have C sharp and B in the 11th and 14th fret and one tone above. So these are the notes. Back to F sharp. Let's see the notes on the third string. It starts from the third and the fifth string on F sharp on the 9th and 11th fret and one tone below to E. Let's see the timing. You play the E twice. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3. All right, let's do only these two bars. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3. And then we have the note of D, one tone below the note of E, that we play twice at 8th. And then another time sliding to the note of C. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 1. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 1. And let's add two more notes on the fifth string. B, half tone below C, and C again. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 1, 2, 3, 4. Again, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 1, 2, 3, 4. And if we combine it to the whole thing, it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 1, 2, 3, 4. Again, 1, 2, 3, you start at the 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, and 4, and slide 1. And then we finish half tone below A, after above A and the note of A, on the 7th and 9th fret, on the 6th and 4th string. To play down for all the beats. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 1, and 2, 3, 4, 1, and 2, and 3, 4. Now you need to make sure that you play it accurately and freely, because the first part, the first task for you as a student for improvisation is to make sure that you have a right technique and good sound. So you need to be able to play it before you improvise with it. Let's say that you practice, and now let's go to the next stage. The next stage is to take the same song, the same chords, and try to manipulate the phrases a little bit, so it will help you get out of playing exactly what Django plays and making improvisation with it. The basic phrase is, now let's see if I can create variations that are similar to that. All right, it's simple. Just to make sure that you can play with the idea and you are not stuck with it, it will make it easier for you to create new sentences. Next stage is that you try to compose new improvisation, but you keep the essence of two phrases, two bars, like a motif, and then a different so, a different idea. 1 2 3 and so when I organize my solo in this structure and I follow the rhythm pattern and the feel of Django's playing, it helps me feel the two bars easily. So of course you can compose a completely new two bars pattern or four bars pattern, but in the beginning it's very helpful to follow Django's footsteps and repeat exactly what he does, just change the note and the rhythm a little bit. Let's see how we can implement it over other songs, and that you'll see that it always works great. So let's take all of me for example. Let's play the melody so you get to our ears. And I will start now. We are on E. Goes to E, to A minor. Goes to D. My improvisation in a structure that always sounds good, and if you get used to it you can just use it in your improvisation over any song. For example, blues in G, 1 2 3 and this is two bars sentence. So you see the same pattern, you can work with it on every song. Two bars, and four bars. Let's do it with single note. Let's take Coquette for example. 1 2 3 melody. And two bars, and now four. B part, two bars, four bars. With octaves. All right, so you see the, I hope you get the understanding of what it means to think in shapes. When you think in shapes, you look on the music, not shape, structure. When you think in structures, you look at the music from a higher stage. You need, of course, to learn the triads and to have a solid foundation of arpeggios so you can be free and think about the music. But after you know some triads, even, you know, very basic triad, you can still play beautiful solos. For example, let's take a minor swing. 1 2 3 and only A minor, only D minor, and now it was a four bars. So you see, if you follow the structure of playing two bars and four bars, you can improve your improvisation with any skills that you already have, even if you don't learn something new. This is exactly what I'm showing you in my full course about Django Reinhardt's minor swing recording from 1947. You will learn to improve your improvisation with the skill that you already have. If you want to learn the complete solo, get all the tools that you can learn to implement in your playing, either if it is a structure or licks and phrases. There are many ideas here that will improve your improvisation tremendously. This is an amazing solo. There is so much to learn from it. And by learning to play Django solo note by note, you also improve your technique, your sound, flow and speed. So if you want, you can join my complete course about minor swing 47 to get the maximum benefit that you can from this song. I'd love to read your comments. Let me know if you love this concept of playing with structures. It's important for me to hear it from you. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel so you won't miss any of my other free videos. Cheers.